Good afternoon and welcome to Scotland for live coverage of the 2017 Total BWF World Championships. Welcome back to our viewers from earlier today. I'm Bobby Griffin, introducing the second session of semi-finals live from the Emirates Arena. Well, we've whittled down the 356 players that managed to stay at the front of the pack and get to these World Championships in Glasgow to just 23 players now remaining, all of whom converge here this week from 43 different nations from all over the world. And those 23 remaining players hail from just six different countries: Denmark, China, Indonesia, Japan, Korea, and England. Well, it's been an incredible week. Let's take a look at some of the best of the action so far. Semi-finals day, we've got an incredible lineup of matches which start with men's singles. The current world number one from Korea, Son Wan Ho, faces arguably the greatest player of all time, five times world champion, looking to make it a record sixth. It's Lin Dan of China. Women's doubles follows with the ninth seeds Fukushima and her partner Hirota of Japan, making their senior world championship debut together. What a week they're having. They're up against the 2015 runners-up and Olympic silver medalists from Denmark, Christina Pedersen and Camilla Ritter-Yule. In the mixed doubles, the last British hopes for a gold medal, the darlings of English badminton, husband and wife team Chris and Gabby Adcock, are up against the bright young stars of mixed doubles, the most successful players in all of badminton over the last 12 months, Zheng Siwei and Cheng Qingchen. We have an all-Chinese men's doubles matchup. Both pairs came from 2019 down in last night's quarter-final, saving match points to secure a bronze and guarantee a silver or gold medal for China. Chai Biao and Hong Wei facing Liu Cheng and Zhang Nan. Finally, women's singles, the world junior champion China's Chen Yufei up against two times world champ bronze medalist and current Olympic silver medalist from India, Pasala Venkata Sindhu. Well, our first semi-final up, men's singles. Six different nations feature in the quarterfinals. Lin Dan, the last hope of a Chinese player to make it a gold or silver. He'll be looking to try to make it through to meet Victor Axelsen in tomorrow's final. Well, I'm pleased once again to be joined in the commentary box by a former Danish national head coach, Lars. What are your expectations for the second session of semi-finals today?
Well, I have great expectations. We have an amazing lineup of matches here, so I'm looking forward to it.
Yeah, me too. Particularly our first match, Lin Dan, five times world champion, Son Wan Ho, number one in the world at the moment. It's going to be a real cracker. Well, Lin Dan to start the match. Nearest us at the bottom of your screens at home, 33 years of age, from Fujian in China. Current world number seven, of course, but a man that needs no introduction. Former world number one and arguably the best player that's ever lived. Well, he's doing things the hard way at times in this tournament. That round three victory over Rajiv Youssef of England, a real test for Lin Dan. And that was just after that incredible match with Emil Holst, 21-16 in the third, 82 minutes of play, looking formidable in yesterday's quarter-final. Son Wan-ho, the 29-year-old from Gyeongsangnam-do in South Korea, current ranking number one. He's been such a consistent performer over the last 12 months or so. And I did worry for him yesterday with his particular draw. Sangson Boonsak of Thailand, no easy opposition, and took 72 minutes to put out the Thai 11 seed. And that quarter final against Kadambi Srikanth looking so strong.
Thank you.
Well, the head-to-head, Lin Dan leads 10-2, but last they've met four times in the last 2 years, that head-to-head, in those four matches, 2-2. Their last meeting there, as you can see, 21-16 in the third to Lin Dan. What is your interpretation of that head-to-head? Can we really take much stock in that particular graphic?
I'm sure that Son Wan-ho, he's looking more at the last four encounters than the total head-to-head score, and that's where he should find his confidence in before today's match.
Yeah, absolutely. Both of those results for Son Wan-ho, he was unseeded in each event.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my right,
and Lin Dan ranked
Lin
particularly
Dan,
highly.
China. And on my left, Son Wan-ho, Korea. Son Wan-ho, 2-star. Bravo. Great.
And Son Wan-ho with the opening serve. That umpire, by the way, Mr. Toi Tsutomu, getting play underway.
One back.
Well, Lin Dan already calling for a change of shuttle. Son Wan-ho walking over to Bert van Horenbeek, today's service judge for this men's single semi-final. Well, great net play already, and an easy kill for Son Wan-ho after that net cord. Lars, I always feel like Son Wan-ho is overlooked. He's been number one in the world for quite some time now. And he easily walked into the Dubai Super Series finals as number one seed in that event. How is it that we don't really talk about him as much as other players as a expected men's singles champion at the World Championships?
I don't think this time when he's top seeded you can't rule him out, but he doesn't have a lot of titles. He has been among the top players for quite a few years now, but he hasn't managed to win a lot of titles yet. So I think that's why he's not counted amongst the biggest favorites before this tournament. But it will be very interesting to see today if he can end the Chinese supremacy in this discipline. The last time we had a non-Chinese world champion in men's singles was in 2005, where Taufik Hidayat of Indonesia won. Since then, of course, Lin Dan has won five titles, Chen Long has won two, and Chen Jin has won one. So it could be the first time for a very long time that we will have a new country on top in this discipline.
Service over. 3-2.
Well, Son Wan-ho hoping to make the first Korean in the final, perhaps the first Korean for some time to take the men's singles title. But either of these two will be facing a man in incredible form. That victory for Victor Axelsen of Denmark earlier today against the current world champion Chen Long. Last, did anyone really expect that kind of performance and that kind of scoreline, really? Victor Axelsen coming through so easily against Chen Long earlier.
I think one of the players who prior to the tournament could be expected to threaten Chen Long was indeed Axelsen. He has been close before and has beaten him, of course, but the score is really what amazes me most about that match. It was a very, very impressive performance by Axelsen.
Plenty of support for Lin Dan, not just here, but wherever he goes in the world. So many supporters of this badminton great. Good length from Lin Dan on these lifts. Oh, that's brilliant from Lin Dan. I thought he'd won with the clip cross smash. Impressive, Sun Wan Ho even able to get a racket underneath that shot, but great control from Lin Dan. What is it that makes Lin Dan such a likable figure in badminton? Is it just the results?
No, it's not just the results, but of course that's a big part of it. He wouldn't be near as popular if you stripped him of all his titles. But it's also the way he plays. Like he's a great character and with a sublime technique. And then he has managed other singles players who has been around for a long time, that they don't have the explosiveness as they had when they were in their 20s. But if you want to play singles beyond 30s, then you probably have to reinvent yourself and change your style. And if you compare the style today of Lin Dan with, say, when he won the 2008 Olympics, it's a way different style of play. He's playing much more patient now. But I think that just adds to the credit to him that he has been able to do that. A player like Peter Gade did the same thing because he got an injury and didn't have the same speed when he came back. But then he reinvented himself and became a more all-round player. And you could argue that a kind of the opposite thing has happened with Sun Wan Ho. When he first came around, he was very defensive. And he has actually turned himself into a more aggressive player. So it's and in men's singles today, it's very hard just to play one style. You have to be an all-rounder, and then you have your strengths maybe somewhere. But you have to be able to do everything because the opposition is so strong nowadays. Oi.
Yeah, I find that fascinating about Sun Wan Ho. It's usually the other way around. A younger player would start off more aggressive and then perhaps learn that control and defensive style like Lin Dan is doing, more control, more patient. But Sun Wan Ho, not a young man in badminton terms anymore, is closing in on the age of 30. Amazing to see him suddenly start playing more fast, more aggressive.
Yeah, and I like watching him much more now, because it's much nicer to see a mix instead of just the same style all the time, and it's definitely much more difficult for the opponents.
Well, a style that's working for Sun Wan Ho, such a consistent performer, always at the latter stages of events, every event he enters, in fact.
The service is over. 6-9 7-9
Sun Wan Ho misfiring with the smash.
Yeah, and he maybe got a little bit too eager here, and up until now he has been very very strict on keeping his discipline, and that's in my opinion very important, because one of the things that that I maybe forgot before, but is also one of the absolute strengths of Lin Dan, that's the tactics and the mental coolness. And he's very good at, in the long rallies, making the opponent run more than himself. But up until now, I think that Sun Wan Ho has also been equally good at moving Lin Dan. And that's it's important that he keeps doing that, so he doesn't wear himself down before the deciding parts of the match.
Oh, what an exchange at the net.
8-9
Great cross net from Sun Wan Ho. The net cord picked up, and Lin Dan
players
ready and waiting to pounce.
Play on.
We've seen it all week in the men's singles game in particular. So much won and lost at the net. Victor Axelsen showed us earlier today how important it was to take control and get the attack.
10-8
Judgment, Lin Dan letting that one fall long up the back line. Pick up from a great straight drop from Lin Dan. An incredible net play once again. That spin with the forehand net so tight, nothing Sun Wan Ho able to do about it. judgment. That one's so close.
11.
The lift 10, into Lin Dan's backhand corner wide, and it's Lin Dan that comes from behind to take us to the break. 11-10.
然后后场他如果回的话高球回的话这时候有起来要有点加快一点打下压对抓的他就一下感觉我不应该发你打完连上方对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对对
Yeah, and as is oftentimes the case with very experienced players, then it's more the coaching or the mid-game intro is more a discussion
11,
than
10. Brave.
Than just the coach telling what they see. So and I think that's a good thing when the players contribute with their point of view.
Both players again looking to take control of the net this time. Under some pressure. Someone Ho's kill out of the side, but they almost looked as if it came off the racket of Lin Dan. Very difficult to see from that angle, and I don't think the umpire aware of that either. However, both the highest regard of professionalism, they get on with the match regardless of that controversial point. And again, is the net play of Lin Dan getting the better of Son Wan Ho.
Yeah, and now it's the fourth point that Son Wan Ho loses in his short or forehand net corner, and I think the one we saw before, he actually made a good choice, but he has to be careful with his choices at the net and maybe lift Lin Dan a little bit more to the rear court to create some more open space before he plays the front court.
Yeah, we saw a similar tactic from both Brad Youssef and Emil Holst earlier in the week.
11, 13.
Trying to tire Lin Dan, using those rear corners more than the net. Good cross smash from Son Wan Ho. Lin Dan almost able to carry that one over the net.
Break.
Hear how tight the strings are on Lin Dan's racket if we get a moment to enjoy that sound. Lars, what kind of tension would these top singles players be carrying in their rackets?
I'm not completely sure what these players prefer, but it's strong a lot tighter than what we use in a club level. So. And that's also why we see them actually break quite often. If they miss hit it a little bit, then the string breaks and they have to change to a new racket.
challenge from Son Wan Ho. That net shot
called
wide.
Out.
I think this was a great lead from Lin Dan. Well, here's the result, and yes, just a millimetre or two wide of that line.
Remaining.
Incredible service judgment over. From Lin Dan.
14-13.
Another great net spin on the forehand from Lin Dan. Longest rally of the game so far, I believe. And Son Wan Ho opting to use those rear corners more than earlier. That one out, backhand corner of Lin Dan. More great judgment.
But we can see on this one, Lin Dan is really anticipating these cross-court attacks from Son Wan Ho's around the head corner. And he has to vary it a little bit more. He has a very good straight slice from the same position and maybe a straight stick smash as well to move Lin Dan away from Lin Dan's forehand side in that situation.
The attack, Son Wan Ho into the body of Lin Dan, setting
14,
up the kill.
15.
Yeah, and this time he goes down the line, the long line, and can follow it up. Whereas the last couple of times when he has gone cross court, this was a little bit better situation as well. But then he has been in trouble afterwards from the straight block from Lin Dan.
Technically such a good mover, Son Wan Ho. You watch him move around the court, it's so efficient, wastes no energy with misplaced footsteps. So strong in the legs, economical. Oh, brilliant block backhand from Son Wan Ho. The drop from Lin Dan perhaps too far into court, not close enough to the line to threaten the man from Korea. Brilliant attack though from Lin Dan.
A service over. 16-all.
It's the shot to the net that got him the advantage once more. Son Wan Ho outstretched so far he couldn't recover in time to face the cross smash. Well, as expected, this one, a very close encounter. Son Wan Ho won't be threatened by another potential long match with top-class Chinese opposition. That Rio Olympic quarterfinal he played against Chen Long. That was 1 hour, 37 minutes. Went deep into a third game, and a previous world championship result for Sun Wan Ho, Du Pengyu, in 2013. That one almost an hour and a half as well.
17-16.
Was even better from Lin Dan.
18-16.
Yeah, and once again, Sun Wan Ho gets in trouble after playing a little bit too loose shot to Lin Dan's forehand side at the net, and that corner where at the net where they both have the forehand side is has turned out to become a problem for Sun Wan Ho. That's where he makes a little bit too many wrong choices.
Great diving defense from Lin Dan. Incredible pickup. Another one's gone wide.
19-16.
Lin Dan's judgment on point today. That's so many, so close to the lines that Lin Dan has left and have fallen out. That must be 5 or 6 points for Lin Dan. That Sun Wan Ho looking for these lines. So that forehand corner, Lars, at the net you were talking about, is it simply that Lin Dan is technically better in that corner, has more options available?
No, because he's very good in the backhand corner as well. But I think that it's he's very aware of the opportunities that comes in that corner, and probably he has analyzed on video that's maybe normally a corner that Sun Wan Ho is playing a little bit as a safe corner. When he doesn't exactly know what to do with, of course he knows what to do, but doesn't have a very aggressive idea with the shot. So he's very aware of meeting it early there, Lin Dan.
Well, Lin Dan at the top of his game at the moment, and he's earned himself game point serving 20-16. Another good tight net shot from Lin Dan. Oh, and for once, Lin Dan's judgment not quite up to scratch.
20.
Yeah, that one a few inches in. Might not look like much, but in badminton terms, I think Lin Dan, something happened there to leave that shot. It wasn't ever looking to be that far out of the court. So serving to save another game point. Great diving defense again from Lin Dan. Oh, the follow-up is, wow.
Song Wan Ho challenging. Called out.
Desperate dive from Lin Dan, unable to get strings behind that shuttle. Lin Dan leaves it. Song Wan Ho's challenge thinks it's in. The line judge called it out. Such an important point. And it's out. Lin Dan takes the opening game.
Game. First game won by Lin Dan. 21-17.
Well, to the delight of the crowd, Lin Dan playing somewhere near his best badminton in recent years at least. And he's taken the opener, 21-17.
Korean coaches Kim Ki-jun and Argo Santoso, they really really have to help Son Man-ho find a good plan now, because now he's playing with the drift on the slightly faster end of the court, and that's normally in men's singles not an advantage. So it'll be exciting to see what plan they've made here to turn this match back in favor of the Korean.
Well, you might have noticed the response from the crowd during the interval there. Son Wan-ho might be world number one and the number one seed here, but it seems he's the underdog. The crowd fully behind Lin Dan, the legend of men's singles, who is now a game up in
Brave.
Well, a little under half an hour. We've seen entire matches so far this week take much less time than that opening game for Lin Dan and Son Wan-ho.
Service over. One dot.
A great play from Son Wan-ho in that opening rally. Speed 360 kilometers per hour. That's right up there in the men's singles game. Lin Dan playing with confidence. You can tell by the shot choices and the execution from Lin Dan in that rally. Three or four times showing us that deception he's able to put into the shots. Lift to the forehand rear corner by Lin Dan. Well, he's got to be careful. careful there, Lin Dan. What do you think, Lars? He almost used the deception wrongly. He could have taken the shuttle earlier. It was read by Son Wan Ho, but the Korean was unable to take advantage.
Yeah, you're right that the quality of the shot after the deception from Lin Dan was not as he would have liked it to be, but Sun Wan Ho got a little bit too eager, and I think already now, after the first two rallies, Lin Dan realized that, okay, Sun Wan Ho, he's, as he probably expected, going to be more or even more aggressive from this end of the court, and then he took one step forward and tried to now to control the game a little more, so Sun Wan Ho doesn't get these opportunities to attack. And when he has to attack, it's when he's a little bit out or slightly out of balance.
Yeah, Lin Dan playing from the slower end of the court. We've seen some drift in this arena from bottom to top, which means Lin Dan is playing into the drift, slowing his shots down very slightly. Some drift left to right also. Incredible smash from Lin Dan. Forehand rear corner cross court just inside the line.
Yeah, and definitely the attacking shot that has given Lin Dan the most points in, and most crucial points in particular in this tournament so far.
Son Wan Ho.
4-3.
Another desperate dive from Lin Dan. He is happy to defend from his knees so often.
Thank you.
Well, uncharacteristic error from Son Wan Ho in the deep rear corner. Yeah, let that shuttle drop just a couple of inches below where he would have perhaps liked to take it. Oh, great pickup from Son Wan Ho. And that's a better smash. Less power, more control.
Yeah, and it's really important that Sun Wan Ho keeps his patience and finds the right height to play the rear corner. So because Lin Dan is very good at intercepting the shots if they're too flat, the lift and the clear. So the right height to the rear court and not to attack while he's still a little bit out of balance, because then Lin Dan is probably the best counter-attacking player in the world.
Yeah, it's the anticipation that's always amazed me about Lin Dan. He seems to know where the shuttle's going to be played more often than any other player, which is why he always seems to look so early onto shots.
Six, five.
Talking about before, when he finds the perfect height to the back corners or the rear corners, then it's difficult for Lin Dan to get out of the pressure, and that's where he can create the attacking opportunities. Sun Wan Ho.
Thank you.
The busiest we've seen from Bert van Horenbeek. Our service judge today, no errors so far on serve, just the odd change of the shuttle.
The service is over. 7-6.
Just like you were saying, Lars, it's the shots before that set up the rally. Getting better length with the right trajectory.
Prayers.
Energetic advice there from the dance coach Xia Xuan Tse, who himself won this tournament also on the British Isles in 2003 in Birmingham, to the right here, who always wears his collar, Eric Cantona style.
Well, that one a bit short from Lin Dan, too easy for Sun Wan Ho, the cross smash. Sun Wan Ho give Lin Dan the shorter lift. Little deception. And then a big gap to Amap. impressive defending from Lin Dan. And it's gone wide.
10-8.
Well, it's been point for point most of this second game. Lin Dan now ahead by two. Good length this time with the clear from Lin Dan. And good length back from Song Wan Ho. The punch clear into the backhand corner. Inch perfect.
Yeah, and Lin Dan indicates that the clear gets a little bit of help from the sideways drift that comes in from left to right, and that's why he's misjudging it.
Thank you. Great.
And if I was the Korean coaches, I would advise Sun Man Ho to make more use of this around the head corner of Lin Dan, because it's definitely from his deep forehand side he creates most of his points.
Great net play, fairly good length on the lift from Song Wan Ho. That one's definitely going wide, and it's Lin Dan in front. Well, words from the Chinese coaching staff that his return of serve has been too flat on occasion.
Hello! 12-9.
Something for Lin Dan to improve upon. Great deception on the reverse slice from the backhand corner. That shuttle dying of speed. He was back behind the smash so well that he knew he could afford to just charge in and follow up that smash. Down the backhand side of Song Wan Ho. From Lin Dan, and he's up again, but he can't keep it going.
Service over.
Too much
10,
to ask.
14.
Good awareness from someone. Ho. How on earth did Lin Dan pick up the second? Unbelievable.
Thank you.
But this time, Sun Wan Ho kept his calm and just kept playing the rally and finished it very, very safely. Sometimes you can get a little bit too eager when the opponent dives and you think it's a very, very good opportunity.
Yeah, all credit to Sun Wan Ho for keeping his nerve. If Lin Dan had won that rally after those defensive shots, he would have been in such good momentum, good spirit to see him through this second game. Taking no chances, Lin Dan. But he's left the straight smash. It might just be wide out into those lines. Nervous moments for Sun Wan Ho. 4 points behind and a game behind. Oh, it's in. It's well in.
Correction in. 11, 14.
Yeah, good call by Sun Wan Ho here, and I think for him a crucial point that he feels that something is going his way. He needs a little bit of encouragement in order to be able to come back here.
Oh, one of Lin Dan's favorite deceptive shots. Sun Wan Ho aware of it this time. Oh, Lin Dan's got a racket onto the drive. But once more, Sun Wan Ho keeps his composure in attack. That drop shot almost getting the better of Lin Dan. Crunch defense.
Change shot.
And a smash down the middle of the court.
Break.
Sun Wan Ho going for the ambitious cross
15,
block.
12.
Lin Dan just turning that screw. The pressure building. Sun Wan Ho facing one of the greatest men's singles players of all time. Just 6 points from a place in the World Championships final. Oh, another desperate dive to Lin Dan. He's back on his feet. And again.
Service over. 13-15.
For Sun Wan Ho, not put off by the dramatic diving defense of Lin Dan.
No, and even though Lin Dan ends up on the floor here, as we see it, then twice, then he is, for me, by far the best ever men's singles player. And he can, if he wins here today, and he can continue that streak tomorrow and actually win the title, he can write even more history, because then he will become the only player to hold six World Championship titles.
Yeah, only three players in history hold five gold medals. I won the last. Do you know the other two?
Park Yobong and Zhao Yunlei.
Yeah, absolutely right. Lin Dan, the only man in men's singles, of course. Park Yobong, two men's doubles gold medals and three in mixed doubles. And Zhao Yunlei, similar watch, a finish. From Lin Dan again, so sharp at the net. Oh, what a spinning net shot, caught the tape, but in so early. The return wasn't bad from Son Wan-ho.
No, but I'm convinced that a lot of the tactical preparation from the Chinese camp has been around this corner where both players have their forehand at the net, because Lin Dan has been very, very keen on taking the initiative there.
17-13.
Well, that lift to the forehand corner of Son Wan-ho, snatched at Son Wan-ho's smash in the net, and I think that might have just sealed his fate. Might be a little early to call, but 4 points behind. Lin Dan needing just 4 points for victory. Yeah, I was saying earlier, that's third player in history that's won five gold medals. Zhao Yunlei, two in women's doubles, three in mixed doubles. But Lin Dan looking at a great opportunity to get to tomorrow's final and the chance to make it a sixth World Championship gold.
17.
Yeah, and this time it's Lin Dan who gets a little bit too eager to kill the shuttle. Just goes slightly wide here and in the side where the sideways drift takes the shuttle a little bit wide.
Going for the deceptive double action net.
14.
Ambitious to try at this stage of a World Championship semi-final. Lin Dan certainly wasn't fooled by the deception, and Son Wan-ho lacking the quality in the shot. Lin Dan ahead by four. Great length from Lin Dan, and what a cross smash!
19-14.
Well, Lin Dan looking calm again, happy to keep the rallies going. He's got a great lead and a fantastic tactic. All the pressure on Son Wan-ho.
14.
And you could see it in how wild that cross smash was. So much tension. Son Wan-ho, Mr. Semi-Finals himself.
Prayers.
Oh, a familiar sight, Lin Dan serving at match point and a chance to make it through to the World Championship final tomorrow. He's done it. First time of asking, what a performance from this legend of the sport. Disappointment for Son Wan Ho. He hasn't quite figured out the game plan, how to beat
match
Lin Dan.
21-17, 21-14.
But Lin Dan looking in great form. He's through to another World Championships finals in straight games, but a few minutes under an hour. 21-17, 21-14. Well, Lin Dan, you little beauty, a chance for a sixth gold medal in World Championships. What a week for him. Fantastic for the crowd, Lin Dan staying, posing for a few selfies, signing a couple of autographs. What a professional this man is. Well, the final for the men's singles decided. Both men in straight games, Lin Dan through Victor Axelsen in an even more impressive performance this morning. He's made it through to tomorrow's men's singles final. I simply cannot wait. Let's take a look at some of the best of that men's singles. What a day of action already. World Championships 2017. We're in Scotland. We're at the Emirates Arena. And Lin Dan, the legend of men's singles, has just made it through to give himself a chance of a record-breaking sixth gold medal if he can overcome Victor Axelsen in tomorrow's men's singles final. We've got women's doubles action for you next. It's Fukushima and Hirota of Japan, the number 9 seeds. They're up against Christina Pedersen and Camilla Juul of Denmark, the number 2 seeds. Well, you can see there, one of the players in today's semi-finals, Chen Qingchen of China, and her partner, Jia Yifan, through to the women's doubles final. Chen featured in the mixed double semis finals as well. They await the winner of this semi-final here in women's doubles.